Hi, I'm Scott Backes and I'm here with Petzl to show you the new JAG system. It's an innovative system that's an integrated 4-to-1 haul system with a built-in sock. And what this does for the system is keeps the ropes from tangling. And as someone who's spent a lot of time using 4-to-1s, I can tell you it's very easy for them to get tangled. So what you have with this system is two carabiners at the top and bottom, an 8mm rope, a progress capture pulley system that gives you a 4-to-1 mechanical advantage. The actual components look like this. The top system is what we call the JAG Traxion, and what it is it has a cam that's built into the top to capture the progress when you're raising the load. It has a becket so that you can tie off the rope there, and it has two very efficient pulleys, which together give about 91% efficiency, which is very high for pulleys this size. You'd lock the cam down onto the rope and start the haul. The bottom part of the unit is a very lightweight, small, and efficient double pulley system. This is a really great system anytime you'd want to raise someone off of their dorsal D. And this length is optimized for that. It's 1 meter long and is almost the perfect length for getting someone who's fallen on a dorsal D, busted their shock pack, and is hanging in a position where they may get suspension trauma. This system can get them off of that dorsal D onto the rope, and you can lower them to the ground quickly and efficiently. So the components of the JAG system we've gone through, but I just want to show you what it looks like on the inside. You'd take a carabiner out of the top, pull the sock down, and the rope is terminated with a sewn termination. The end of the rope is not only sewn but knotted so that it can't get sucked through the device, so that you have extra safety there, and that's basically the top of the unit. The bottom of the unit, again, sock comes off, and there it is threaded with the 8mm rope. One more way that Petzl makes the JAG a very easy system to use is the ends are color-coded. Victim is in the black, operator is in the yellow. Makes it very, very simple for you at single glance to grab the unit and know that this is the correct end to have on top. In a system, you may want it to be a closed system. And by a closed system, I mean that the system cannot be tampered with. And I've set one up right now using several components that I think make almost the best system available. But on the bottom, instead of using the carabiner, what we've got is a ring that you can open, but then using a 3mm Allen key, but then close it up again, keeping this system so that it cannot be opened unless you use that Allen key. It's connected to an ID descent control device, and with that ID, we've taken it and actually put this screw through here, and that closes the ID so you can't get in, and once the system is rigged correctly, it's completely ready to go. The operator can't get in, can't change the rope path. The system ends up being, you hang the system up, you raise the victim on the cam, disconnect the dorsal D, and go into lower mode on the ID. All that simple and that quickly and safely. The system allows you to do that sort of a rescue with a minimum amount of fuss and with a lot of time savings. Together, that system, I think, revolutionizes tower rescue.